this opportunity to wish the players, officials, and supporters of the Crusaders a safe journey home tonight. Hey, Andy Waterbury. Officials and players of Clangor.
Yeah.
Shore for number 10, Kevin Kelby. I'd also like to take this opportunity to wish the Glentoran team all the best for Monday night in the semi-final at the Zapata Cup at Drogheda.
chance to pull them down. Thank you.
fans and supporters of Grand Island a safe journey home.
Thank you. Thank you.
at all. We hope it doesn't need to be used, but it's there if it does.
Number 9, Curtis Allen. I'd like to take this opportunity to wish the supporters, officials, and players of Missouri SAFE Charity Game. Once again, thank you for coming to the event.
Clear. Sponsors of Forza TV, Channel Glentoran.
The team men who provide the match statistics to the club, the amount of match vote after each game, and this award is based on the number of votes received for each player. Shane McCain. Well done, Shane. Welcome to today's match, the JKB Sports Premiership against Glentonville. On behalf of Glentonville Football Club, I would like to welcome everyone to the Oval for today's JKB Sports Premiership match.
Thank you.
365. That's the winning number is 0102.
George Neal.
grandmother, Chris Kyle. Sports psychologist, John Kahan.
You're right there.
Get down on it! Get down on it if you want it!
League champions, first test 2005. How do you feel?
Absolutely delighted. I think, truthfully, we deserved it over the whole season. We're a better team, we played the better football, made it very difficult for ourselves, but definitely deserve a champion.
Thanks very much, Nicky.
Worry, league champion, how do you feel?
Absolutely superb. You know, it's been a stop-start season for us. People should have been ahead by Christmas time when the boys weren't doing so well. But, you know, the character in the team, at the start of the game, we had 11 players who were league champions before. And this is just every bit of special. It's absolutely superb. It's been a long season, I'm just delighted.
Many congratulations, sir. Well done.
Thank you. Was that pitching in?
Quick word, champions again. Unbelievable, unbelievable feeling. Long time coming, but well deserved, wasn't it?
Your first championship as chairman of Glentoran Football Club. How do you feel?
Oh, fantastic, Paul. This whole week has been dreadful in terms of not sleeping and nerves. And we did a very professional job. We did what we had to do, and by God, did we do it well. Proud of every single one of them. 4 years, we've been waiting for this a long, long time. It tastes really sweet.
Thanks very much. Well, Leaper, another championship with Glentoran. How do you feel?
It feels fantastic. It's been a hard season. It's been the hardest season I can ever remember. And say, just glad to get over the finishing line today. Second half, we didn't make it easy for ourselves again, but, you know, I'm just delighted. I can't put it into words. I'm over the moon. But the start of every season, you set out to win your league. That's the bread and butter competition. We've managed to do that, and it's just great to have Gibson Cup back in East Belfast.
Well done, Paul.
Thanks very much.
Been a Glentoran fan my whole life. If I hadn't been here, probably playing today, I probably would have been out there on the pitch. Oh, it's a strange feeling. It's strange because I used to come, I remember against Portadown 30 years back, I was on the pitch with Scott Young. I can't even take it in yet. It's unreal.
Well, Darrell, league champion, how do you feel?
Tremendous. 10 months of hard work, and all came down till today, and to win 3-1 today was brilliant. Our first half performance actually won us the game, and really happy. The priority is the league. We want the league, and today we got that.
Thanks very much, Dan.
It's flipping brilliant. Dream come true as well. Scoring at the end of the season, down to the last game of the season. That's what it's all about, you know. And it's just brilliant, you know, to win the league. You know, 1-1 with Portadown, and it's even better here. That's what I come here for.
I'm over the moon, like, over the moon for the boys and everybody involved. Like, I mean, at the end of the day, it's not about me, it's about the club. And we brought the Gibson Cup home again, so I mean, that's the most important thing. As far as to me, I've all summer to recover again. You know, obviously, I would prefer to have no hamstring injury, but I'll go all summer and work at it. So I look forward to next year too.
This is what I come back to Glentoran for. I've been at Glentoran now nearly 9 years, and that's my first league medal. Missed out the last time when down at Seaview. Just signed my first professional contract and didn't play enough games, so it was. I was very hungry for this day to come and hope.
Well, David, league
more
champions, how do you feel?
Unbelievable. Last Irish League club I was at, and no disrespect to Lauren, but we were fighting relegation every year. We fell at the last hurdle last year, but this year it's unbelievable. So it's just, it hasn't sunk in yet, to be fair. But that group of players have been unbelievable. It makes a long, hard 10 months just all worthwhile. So it does. It's brilliant.
And Elliot Morris, what would you say about him?
The guy is a class act. His attitude to training's unbelievable. He does everything I ask him to do. He's the last one off the training pitch every week. And to be honest now, if you look at the save he made at Coleraine last week and the save he made in the first 3 minutes today, I think it just turned to two games for us. If we had a goal down at Coleraine and a goal down today at home to Cliftonville, it may have changed the whole outlook of
Jordy,
the league championship.
You're no stranger to league titles as a player.
Yep.
How does it compare as a coach?
I think it's probably more special. I mean, I was fortunate. I mean, three championships I played in, or one, where the first time was the Untouchables, the second time is to win the double, and the third time is captain. So they're all very, very special to me. But I think when you're a coach or a manager, it's if you multiply it by 11, that's the sort of feeling of despair when it's down and elation when it's up. So I think Scotty, Davey, Alan, myself are all absolutely over the moon. I mean, we sat down 2 years ago and tried to work out, you know, what our objectives were, and the 2 years, our main objective was to win a major trophy, hopefully the league championship. And obviously we're delighted to do it, and beating Linfield, who are just coming from the back of three doubles in a row, is no mean feat. This league championship this year has been a very, very difficult one. There's been more games, it's been tougher, there's been very, very few poor teams against us, and it's been a real battle all year, but everybody's just absolutely ecstatic about doing it and bringing the
well,
trophy
Grant,
back to
you. You broke through to the first team this season, league champions. How do you feel?
It's just brilliant to be playing on the same team as Lieber, Nicky. Names I got there, it's just fantastic, and all the young players have been helped massively by Alan, Scotty and George, and like I said, I've been supported the Glens, and it's just brilliant to win a league
title. Well,
Johnny,
many congratulations, league champion, how do you feel?
Unbelievable, just can't believe it, first year, playing for Glentoran first team, win the championship my first year, hopefully it's the first
time. Probably the best one so far, this is my third, so obviously winning at the Oval, one at the Institute and one at Seaview. Seaview was pretty special because obviously I'm from that street more or less, and but this tops it. This season's been really, really tough. We've had a lot of setbacks and people knocking us back, knocking us down.
you, Grandma! Mama!
Thanks, Sean.
Bit of fun from Sean Ward there.
We got knocked down quite a bit this season. Obviously, our performance went up and down, but we've managed to continue in the end.
It's your second Irish League Championship. Your first with Glentoran. How do you feel?
I felt all week, and I've been saying to a couple of lads that this is my most important game in my whole career. With a bar none, bar FAI Cup finals and league medals with Portadown and things like that, I just felt it was just coming to a point and I just had to win this medal. And nothing would have stopped us from getting the 3 points today. You know?
And of course, we got off to a great start today. Well, you got us off to a great start today. How did you see the goal?
A couple of guys have said to me that they fancied me for a goal today. I felt good myself. Having said that, I haven't played in about 6 weeks. So I had a broken rib coming into the Linfield game, and then after 10 minutes, I thought I broke my ankle. So I thought my season was over, you know. And I worked really hard in gyms and things like that, and got myself back in. And kind of frustrated for the last 2 weeks that the gaffer hadn't put me back in or even on the bench when I was declared fit. So I just knew I had to set a precedent, you know, and just come out from the start, because I didn't want us going in very agitated and nervy and all that. And having said that, it was just great effort from Hamo off the crossbar or off the upright, and I just followed it in and was lucky just to now to slide it back into the far corner, and it turned out it went in, you know.
Well, you're a champion now. Thanks very much, Dino.
You're welcome. Thank you very much.
I'm absolutely ecstatic, to be honest. You know, I don't really worry about the player of the year stuff, although it does mean a lot to you, you know, when you look back on it, but it was all about the championship, you know, and it's all about this medal I have in my pocket, to be honest with you, you know, so I'm absolutely delighted. It's my first, and hopefully it'll not be my last.
Your first league championship at Glentoran, how do you feel?
To be honest, yeah, it hasn't sunk in just yet, but as I say, it's one of the best feelings so far I've ever had in my career. As I say, without being big-headed, I've represented my country, and I've won titles with Portadown, I've won Irish Cups with Portadown, but as I say, this means a lot more to me today, because I come to Glentoran to win big trophies and win majors, and that was my main reason behind signing for Glentoran Football Club, and up until this point I haven't been able to achieve that there, so to finally do it today was great for myself.
And how did you see the game today?
I thought first half we played probably the best football we've played this season, and I thought obviously you come in half time, you're 2-0 up, and the nerves started getting the people, and the second half we didn't maybe keep the ball as much as we should have, but as I say, we won the game 3-1, and to be honest, whoever won the league today, no matter if it was us or Linfield, deserves the title, because this has probably been the hardest title to win in years.
Got there in the end.
Yeah, it's been as I've used before, it's been a roller coaster ride at times, where we've had some fantastic highs and we've had some really bad lows. But
we had a disappointing December. But as I've said all along, I'm very fortunate. I've got a magnificent staff who have helped me unbelievably.
I've got a great bunch of players who are not just a great bunch of players, they're a great bunch of people. And there's some that I feel unfair criticism levelled at them from within and from without during certain periods, whether we could handle the pressure. And certainly over the last 4 weeks, playing against the top six teams, we've shown and they've shown that they can handle it. And I think it's brilliant. It's a great feeling, and I'm so proud of them.
Do you feel since the split, the character of the team has been shown?
Yeah, we talked. It was a little bit of a concern with myself and the staff that if you analyse our performances and results against the top six teams, if you like, before the split, it was a little bit dubious. You know, so but since the splits happened and we had to replay those teams, we've put on a great run. I think we've taken 11 out of 15 points, which is fabulous, and culminated today with winning the championship.
The real highs that you've experienced over the season?
Well, obviously we had a massive high. I know people go on about me using the word massive, but you know, in Setanta was really enjoyable. It was great. You know, and for a part-time club to come within 45 minutes of winning it was a fabulous achievement. You know, and we went to Windsor Park in the Setanta with a young team and won 4-1, which was great. And we've had some great performances here, but we've also had the lows, you know, the likes of Coleraine here losing 3-1 at the Oval and losing at Seaview 3-0, which was really disappointing. But You know, as we said in the first question, you know, we got
there. Things as a player, you've captained Northern Ireland, you've gone to the World Cup with Northern Ireland. How does it feel to win the top prize in Irish League football as a manager?
It's different types of pride. Obviously, when I played for my country and we got the World Cup, obviously it was a very, very special moment in my life. I think this is probably more fulfilling, if I'm totally honest, because of, I think it's 67 competitive games we've played this season. And as a manager or a coach, sometimes during a game you feel helpless, because no matter what instructions you give on, it's not you that's actually doing the work, it's the players. But certainly, this is probably one of the proudest moments of my life, if not the proudest.